a very big lie about time and money, and it has put a lot of persons living in Lagos in a very tight corner and a rat race. And most people are held in it and they don't know. They lie that time is money and time is equal to money. Okay, so I want to show you tonight that time is not equal to money and time is not money. Are you with me? So please, I need you to follow me very well as I help you tonight. I said time is not what? Time is not money. Time is also not equal to money. Okay, so I will begin by saying time is infinitely greater than money. I said what? Infinitely. Infinitely greater than money. The reason is because time is limited, but money can be unlimited. Please follow me. If I spread $1 million for everyone here and say, Roland, $1 million, Pastor Ola, $1 million, every single person, $1 million. Then after giving you the check of $1 million, I tell you, for this $1 million, you have between now and tomorrow morning to spend it before you die. Okay? Now, I've given you money, but I've reduced your time. Suddenly, you just realize that, oh boy, money is not more important and it's not higher than time. I don't know if you are with me. Okay? Suddenly, you begin to try to negotiate. Can I push the days I will have to spend the money forward? I don't know if you are there. Okay? I said no. As I give you this $1 million now, you have to 8 a.m. tomorrow to finish it. And you are out of the earth. Okay? So time is not equal to money. Because I'm trying to correct that foundation. Because there's somewhere I'm taking you to. That foundation has brought a lot of desperation. And it has brought a type of lifestyle based on that wrong understanding. So time is not equal to money because you have limited time. So as you have entered today, nobody can have more than 24 hours. Can you have more than 24 hours in a day? You cannot. So it means your time per day is limited. Maximum is 24 hours. Is it not so? Okay, but you can decide to make the money you want to make within that 24 hours unlimited. You can decide to make more. You can do some jobs. Like, let's say you do normal 8 to 5 job. But to just add to it today, you decided to close from work quickly and do a little taxi work with your car. And you made some extra 10K or 15K. Are you there? To the usual salary you were supposed to collect today. What has happened? You have increased the money that came to you with the same time you have. Are you getting what I'm saying? So time is limited, but money, the more value you render, the more you multiply and increase money. So money can multiply and extend by value, but time can never be extended. Therefore, time is more important than money. You make money so that you can even have more time. Please follow me. I'm taking you somewhere. Give me Psalms 89, verse 47. Remember how short my time is. Remember how what? So, number one, you have only 24 hours in a day. Then, the time you will also leave this world is not within your power. You are not told that you will stay up to 100. Or you will stay up to 80, or you will stay up to 75. You don't know the exact day you are going to leave. So the exact day you are living here, you don't know. And it is time. Your 24 hours, you cannot extend it to 25 or 27. So time on every side hedges you in that I am not within your power to control. I am not within your power to extend. If the controller of time says that you are living here by 65, it's over. So it is very wrong to now say money is equal to time or money is equal to lifetime. Because when you say money is equal to time, the wrong understanding will now be I must use my time to make money. Then you easily get a job for 50,000 and work from 8 to 5 p.m. and give 8 hours of your lifetime, because remember, you said money is equal to time. And when you are employed, a part of your lifetime is collected. Are you there? So you render a part of your lifetime for this period to this period, dedicated to this service for this amount. So that becomes your worth. That means you are worth 50,000 from 8 o'clock to what? To 5 p.m. So you give that whole period of your lifetime daily for 30 days. Because you have this understanding that money is equal to, time is equal to life. Okay? But there's someone else who has decided that time is not equal to life. It's not equal to money. Money is less important to time. My time is limited, but I can make more money with the little time that I have. So this guy begins to work differently. So we take the case of a sister called Deborah as an example. She goes to work. She's serving in Lagos. She gets to work. The work is 8 to 5, 6 p.m. While the work is 8 to 5, 6 p.m., she takes video of hairdo, ladies weave on, Brazilian weave on and all that, while she's at work, working at number 8 to 5. She puts this ladies' hair and all that. She puts it on her WhatsApp. While she's at work, people are placing order. She's telling them that I can deliver it to you. Then she arranged with her boss. She has 12 to 1 p.m. as her off, what's it called, break time. Okay, so she arranged 12 to 1 as delivery time for all the people she that has placed order. Are you there? Place order for the hair that she's selling. Now, she sells this hair, let's say within the month, she's able to sell 5 or 6. Each of them, she makes 15K, 10K here, 15K, 10K here. At the end of the day, she has made more than 50% of the salary she's working from what? From the same 8 to 5 p.m. Then, there's someone that lives around Gowon Estate. His name is Dr. Pete Mene. He wanted to celebrate his wife. I don't know if you are getting me. Then, she also reached out to him that I can do money bouquet for you to celebrate your wife. And all you need to do is send me 100,000. And everything she's spending to do it and all that, she will spend almost 70,000. So she's making between 20 to 30K from inside for just one money bouquet for someone who is wanting to celebrate his fiancée or his wife or the husband. I don't know if you're there. So now she goes to work with a normal 8 to 5, but she has been able to now extend what she gets. She does money bouquet, she sells hair, she does these ones. So what she's doing within the same time that is limited, she has been able to extend the total money she's making within the month beyond what a normal 24 hours can achieve. I don't know if you are here with me. So what has happened? What has happened? Time is limited. Her time has not gone beyond 24 hours, but she has doubled the money she makes daily by a multitasking to extend what she gets. Are you sure you are with me? So you see that the idea and the concept that I have to stay put to one place and say, this is my job. I go here every day. I go here every day to be able to get so and so amount at the end of the month, and tie my life from morning till evening every day for one full month, whereas I have a limited time of just 24 hours per day, and there are other things I would have been able to do to be able to increase my income. So the culture of 8 to 5 is a culture that makes men end up becoming average. Please follow me. It's a culture that makes men do what? End up average. So those that must rise beyond the average lifestyle, they must be those, even if you take 8 to 5 job, you should even take it to say, I'm working here 6 months. I'm working here for the next 1 year. Not like I'm working here to come and retire, no. Or if I'm working here to even retire, I must have a plan that, okay, I'm saving this period from this period to this period because I want to set up this farming business, or I want to set up this saloon business, or I want to set up this catering business, or I want to set up this dry cleaning business. Any culture that makes you spend your morning till evening every day for a monthly salary, and at the end of the day, there is no culture to be able to set up something that you are able to multiply your value. It reduces what you are, because God's ordained plan is never for you to be an employee all your life. You can work for someone all your life, but while you are working there, like now I have Pastor Sam and Pastor Ola, they are working with me. Our type of work, because we are dedicated to the altar, their lifetime is dedicated to the work we are working together. Are you there? Okay, so their work is not secular. Their work is on the altar with me. As we serve on the altar, a time should come where they should be able to say, oh, sir, I've been able to put together so, so, and so, and I want to open a unisex saloon here. And I will have a manager there. Why we are still serving on the altar? Because you see me here serving on the altar, is it not so? Okay, yet I have something I'm doing, but it's not affecting my serving on the altar. So if I want to do something else, I must do something that must not affect this my full-time service to God that I've dedicated myself to. But I'm not restricted from being able to set up something so that I can have more money to live a more flexible life. Okay? So instead of sitting down to give my wife 3 hours to sit down to wash all my clothes, I buy that 3 hours of her time. I give it to dry cleaner. So I pay dry cleaner to buy that time my wife would have been using to wash the clothes, okay, back to her so that I can use our brain for something more useful. Are you there? Okay. There are a lot of things that we have in the house that if I say she should do the children's clothes, after finishing children's clothes, do my clothes, after finishing my clothes, go to market, after going to market, cook my food, after cooking my food, at the end of the day, what I would have turned her to is that she will be busy tying wrapper from morning till what? Till night. At the end of the day, she will just have finished taking care of the house. Are you there? So instead of doing so, I take someone I'm training in school. I said, you do the cleaning. So that cleaning time, I convert it back to my wife. I said, my wife, use the cleaning time to be thinking more. Let's make more money. Are you there? Okay. And at the end of the day, I tell you, by the time I calculate the time I gave my wife back not to do the laundry, the time I gave her back not to do the cleaning in the house, the time I gave her back to do all this, by the time I calculate how much I spent doing that versus how much we have both spent making money, we're in profit. So I buy a time, the time that she's supposed to use to do a lot of things that they call chores, I buy it. Okay?
Then I engage her because I've seen something in her that her brain is working. Her brain is working. Okay, so you need to know when you marry a wife and your wife's brain has fire, you need to know. Don't turn her to housewife. Don't turn a woman that has masters in accounting. He said she should be washing clothes. That's all you could see. Are you not seeing that you have a problem as a man? Once you see a lady and you see her capacity, just remove her from house things. Let her come and put that brain and make money for you. Okay? So when I saw her, there's something I saw. And it's part of your greatness. It's part of your greatness. When a woman that is supposed to be multiplying your money for you, you use her to do cooking wrapper and doing this thing. You see, you will save longer. Okay? So when I saw her, I saw a potential and a capacity. Me, I generate ideas and I take big risk. I know how to take risk. Risk that can wound somebody, I can take it and be okay. And I will not have injury. Okay, so I take risk. But she cannot take risk. So I make decisions, big ones. She cannot make decisions, but she knows how to manage decisions. They are grown men. They don't know the difference between decision making and decision management. They don't know. So they make decisions, but check, after 1 year, they've closed the business. They don't know how to manage decision. Okay? So once money comes like this, I'm already seeing where the money is going to. My wife will say, calm down, calm down, calm down, calm down. We've not paid for this, we've not paid for this. Let me finish the calculation, I will let you know the profit. So she will remove the capital, remove the this one, remove the this one. Because if you leave me alone, plus the capital, everything, I don't know if you understand. It will be spent. So she calms me down to say, no, remove the capital, remove the this, then this is the profit. And remove this expensive from the profit. This is what you have to spend. So budget your expenses based on this amount. Are you there? So by the time she finished giving me that calculation, my eyes becomes open again. I become born again. Then I start planning with what she has told me afresh. I don't know if you are getting me. So far, in all that we have done, she has added so much value to my life because she's able to manage my finances for me better. I can tell you, if she was not in my life, so many mistakes I would have made, and I can say, if I don't have somebody else, if she was not in my life, I don't have somebody else who is playing the role she is playing, so I would have not been where I am today. I'm telling you. You are getting me. So she's the one that, while I am thinking, I'm excited, I've calculated the profit I will make in 2 years' time, she will just say, have you contacted land department? Why not call barrister so and so to help you check if this land is really for sale? I don't know if you get. So she just give that whisper. Many times we just look at the voice of the Holy Spirit. Then I'll begin to ask myself, why did I not think about that? Are you with me? Why did I not think about that? Why am I just excited? Why did I not consider what she just said? It's not that I cannot consider it. Many times, we are fashioned differently. Are you there? So God has brought her into my life to be of a great support to me. So for men too, you need to observe that. For those of you that are already married or for those of you that will get married, many times when you see that your wife has managerial capacity, ability to help you manage, don't try to say, I want to keep my money away from my wife. I don't want her to know everything I have. I don't know if you are there. Okay, there are some women, you show them. It is when you have a wife that today she's asking for Brazilian air, tomorrow she's asking for Italian air, next tomorrow she's asking for British air. If that is the one, then you have to corner what you have before you enter into big trouble. Okay, but when you have someone who has your interest, who is planning with you, to build with you, once you see such a person, there's nothing to hide. You build together. I don't know if you are getting me. So now when I discovered such, I don't now bug her with too much load because I know that the responsibility I'm giving to her is enormous and she needs a lot of thinking, a lot of calculation, a lot of balancing. Because me, I want to fast and pray. I want to do a 3 days dry and I want to off my phone. And I don't want to think about business. I don't want anybody to call me. So all the complaint has to go to her. Oh, this staff is having problem. That other client is complaining. This or that thing. I said, don't tell me. Solve all the problem, then give me a report when I come down from the mountain. Are you getting me? So somebody you have given such responsibility, you cannot be telling her to go and clean kitchen or go and do this one or go and do that one. Are you there? To the point that I had to, even for cooking, I had to say, okay, teach so and so so they can make the meals. So I also removed her from the meal. She only joined them to do major food, put in the fridge and the microwave and give to me when I need. So the stress is so reduced. You want to go to market, send someone else to market. She just transferred the money and someone else comes. So what have I done? I've so reduced all the petty things that are time consuming from this, so that she can have more time to do things that are more productive. Because all these other things you are calculating, so there are things you can undo with lesser amount. Dry cleaner here, this one here, this one here, you have solved them. But this one, if you put her into a profitable venture, she's able to make more money for you and you make millions at the end of the month. So what have you observed? You have been able to do something. You have been able to do something. You have exchanged, you've used money to buy yourself more time. So your 24 hours, 4 hours I supposed to have gone for this, you've been able to buy it back for her. Are you there? Then, as a man, I'm supposed to be doing business and making money to take care of people, to take care of the challenges I have. So, but at the same time, I want to be a full-time pastor. So for me to be able to achieve this now, I have to train her, cook her, explain. I took out time, explain business, explain everything. This is what we are doing. Did the CAC, did everything, build it. Are you with me? Show her everything in and out. Then I said, I want you to be handling this. So look at what I've done. I duplicated myself, poured myself into her, poured my understanding into her, then gave her to handle. Then I faced ministry. I've turned to two. So I'm inside there working the business. I'm inside here. Radikambo, Ibate Zokomo. What has happened? I've been able to increase my 24 hours to 48. You don't know. I don't know if you are there. So the 24 hours that I have, that I'm supposed to give maybe 12 hours to between business, I've been able to buy that 12 hours back by giving her the responsibility to do. Then the other responsibility she was supposed to do in the house, I bought it with lesser money. I don't know if you are there. So if you check the chain of command, you will simply see that life is all about working with the limited time you have, using value to extend the amount of money you want to make. Glory to God. Are you sure you are following me? Okay, let me. I'll give you a better example now so that you'll be able to catch what I'm saying better. Give me Psalm chapter 1, verse 1-3. Psalm chapter 1, verse 1-3. It says, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel. Go to verse 3. It said, it shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that does what? It bringeth what? It bringeth what? Bringeth forth his fruit in his season. Bringeth forth his fruit in his season. Bringeth forth his fruit in his season. Season there is referring to a period of time. Okay? Then, bringeth forth his fruit in his season. So, as we are here, we are different type of fruits. Some are mango fruit. Some are cocoa fruit. Some are banana fruit. I don't know if you are with me. Okay, so whatever fruit you are, whatever tree you are that you are supposed to bring forth, there is a season and a period of time it takes for it to come out. The time it will take for mango to come out is not the same time it takes for cocoa to come out. Are you there? The time it will take for a dog to get pregnant and give birth is not the same time it takes for an elephant to get pregnant and give birth. So whereas a dog might take 9 months, elephant takes 2 years. How many of you know elephant takes 2 years? Okay. So he bringeth forth his fruit in his season. So your season is different from his season. His season is different from his season. His season is different from her season. So the first thing we must get when we are talking about time is that there is a season where I'm supposed to wait. First of all, I'm supposed to know that this is my season. It will last from this time to this time. Then I know when to wait. And the first thing that comes to people's mind when we say you are supposed to know your season and you're supposed to wait is that a lot of persons who are already lazy, they are happy that maybe my season has not reached. Are you getting me? But you need to know whether your season has not even passed and you did not know. So when we said your season has not reached, don't relax and say, oh, it's true. My season has not reached. That's why I've not. No, that's not the understanding. He bringeth forth his fruit in his season. That means you keep doing what you are doing at the right season. Time and chance will happen to make the fruit come into reality. Are you there? And when you arrive at that time, at that right season, you must develop the culture. You must develop the culture of withdrawing from what takes more of your lifetime to developing more value to exchange for your lifetime. I said, you are working and you make 50,000. Okay? Make it a goal and a priority to have a system of training yourself and developing yourself to render a value that is different from that work you are doing. Between now and December, try to say, I now know this thing that I didn't know when I was entering this year. So that I can now give that thing to someone. Okay? And to be able to, many times when you ask somebody, learn a skill or learn something that is different from this work. Many times people say, Pastor, I don't know what to even learn. Okay? One of the fastest way to be able to know what to learn is to sit back and use the psychology of the void in the past, seeking to satisfy the void in the future. Okay? So this is how it works. This is how it works. A guy who grew up in a house that they never had a car will naturally have the tendency to want to have a car in his future to cover up for the void of what he lacked when he was younger. So people tend to want something they lacked as they were growing up. Okay? So the void and the vacuum of the past always create a space for you to occupy for their future. So as I meet you, I extend value to you the moment I'm able to know your void. Now, wow, are you people here? Mary, you are lost there, Abby. Hey, Father, help me tonight. So if I meet Maxwell, and I get into conversation with Maxwell, and while I'm talking with Maxwell, I'm just talking with him naturally. And while he was growing up, he grew up in an area where they always carry their clothes to the stream to wash and all that. And that, to him, was a very tormenting experience. So now that he's a man, he doesn't want to hear anything, wash clothes. Carry it straight to dry cleaner. Are you seeing it now? So it means that once I have a conversation with him, suddenly I already know that a good person that can pick all his laundry and handle it and bring back to him will make him very happy. So I've discovered a void in him that if I'm able to render a value right now to him, he would appreciate. So that is already a value. So concerning Maxwell, there is a value I've already known. Because of his past, he will value laundry. If I find a way to see how, even if I don't have laundry, I just find a way to pack it from him, give it to laundry person, and go and give him back. I've already rendered value to him. Are you there? So when you talk to people, you have the opportunity to hear about their past and the things that happened to them that they don't like. It just automatically gives you a chance of creating value. So value holes are created when you are about to see the void of people's past. So you become a person of value when you are able to see. So look at it. Joseph, like as I was showing you the last Wednesday, Joseph met the other guy. He said, what happened? Why are you people down? And the guy said, we had a dream. So Joseph saw a void because they were once in Pharaoh's house and now they've been thrown into prison. So in their past, somebody has been accused wrongly. So Joseph was able to interpret the dream to them and cover up for that void. And at the end of the day, they remembered Joseph. So Joseph was able to render a value after asking them, why are you sad today? So that same chain of natural care. Why is your face like this? Oh, why are you so excited? All these are entry points to get people talking. So by the time you begin to maintain one-man lane, you don't talk to people. I maintain my business. I maintain my this. I maintain my that. You will not be able to be a very good seller of yourself. So there's something I want to tell you. While you are rising, don't develop the capacity of being a loaner. After you have made money, you can now delegate and have secretary, have this thing, have different person. But at the early stage where you are trying to sell yourself, your mouth must open. You cannot say, I'm shy, I am timid, I am this. You will not go anywhere. You have to overcome it. You have to learn how to speak to people. You have to know how to tell people, this is what I can do. I can make it like this. I can make this clothes for you. I can do this other design. Oh, the madam said, no, I don't like this other design. No, I can put this stone for you. This one will be shining. I don't know if you are there. So you must know how to talk such that each place you go, you are able to get one new client because you know how to talk. You are in the bus, you got a client. You are in the cab, you got a client. You are in church, you got a client. You must know how to talk. You must be able to sell yourself because nobody will come and sell yourself to you. And when you meet the people, the way you sell yourself is not to tell them about yourself. People don't like you telling them too much about yourself. So as I meet Amarachi now, I don't need to come and start telling Amarachi about myself. I just say, wow, I like this, your hair. Oh, I like this, your chain. How is this your hair? It must be very expensive. Say, I know, it's not expensive. You start by
appreciating her. Yes, ah, this your hair, it was very expensive. Ah, no, it's not too expensive, oh, just 25,000. Oh, it's so beautiful for 25,000. Do you know, I can get you something like this for 15,000. Say, what? You can get me for 15,000? Where will you get it for 15,000? What has happened? The moment she said, where can you get it for 15,000? I've gotten an entry point. Conversation don't start. It will lead to many other conversations. I don't know if you are getting me. So, when you want to sell yourself, you forget about yourself and talk everything about the person. People like you telling them about themselves. So, as you are looking at the person, you say, oh, this your eyelash is very fine. I like your eyeballs. It bulges out very beautifully. I like your nose. I don't know if you are getting me. Look at this, your nose. See the way it's pointing like as though. Look at the way it's pointing as though it's surgery. What are you doing? You are just pouring water. You know what you are looking for. You are trying to sell yourself. So when you are trying to sell yourself, you don't talk anything about yourself. What are you talking about? Everything about the person. Admiring him from leg to head. Yeah. Everything the person is doing. Even if the person smiles, you appreciate the smile. What are you doing? You are trying to sell, get the entry point where you will enter from. And at the end of the day, you are able to get the void. Are you there? Once you get the void, you can now establish your value. I said, once you get the void, you can what? Then your value is exchanged for money. Never chase money. Money gravitates towards value. Each value you render brings money to you. So I said, never do what? Never chase money. Money gravitates towards value. Each time you render a value, money gravitates to you. I said value attracts money. So money locates what? Money locates value. So let's take for instance now. He has 100,000 in his hand. 100,000 in his hand. Do you know that everybody that is sitting here right now, we will say we don't have money, but you have some money in your pocket. Huh? When you get to the gate, you have 2,000 in your pocket, and you want to go to your house. You don't want to spend this your 2,000. Then you check. This your leg might not be able to carry you to a Akwanjo roundabout. You will not like the enjoyment trekking to a Akwanjo roundabout. So you don't want to trek. Huh? So what has happened? The moment you say, I don't want to trek, you will put money inside that. You put hand inside that 2,000 and take something from inside and give to who have created that value. So that he can take you to a Akwanjo roundabout. Are you seeing it now? But if that guy had come to ask you for that money without rendering anything, will you give it to him? Okay, so, but I thought you said you didn't have money. When you were living here, you said you didn't have money. Is it not so? How come you gave that bike man money now? Eh? You say? The guy created value. And value knows how to collect what you say you don't have. I said value knows how to do what? So, is it really true that there's no money in Nigeria? This country. Too much money is in this country. Release yourself. So it's value. It's value. There is money everywhere. As you have seen this whole country, so as you have seen everybody's face here, so they will tell you they don't have money, but there is money. As you create the value now, suddenly you will see the money flowing. You will see the money flowing. You will see the money flowing. It will be flowing in the area of value. So please, I want to plead with us. Huh? I don't want you to just leave here hearing sermon and hearing message. This is not a message. That's why you see that I'm not shouting. I'm not reading Bible up and down. I'm trying to explain to you something. between now and June, I want you to add something to yourself. Know something new. A man that is trying to rise, the reason you have not gone up is it means you have not known what you should know. So don't be relaxing as though you have finished knowing. As long as you are rising, you keep learning. You keep adding value. You keep finding ways to know more. That thing you are trying to do, find out how people are making money from it. As long as it is legal, as long as it is legal way to make money and it's not fraudulent, put your eye there. Are you there? Then, they say, no grief for anybody this year. And I'm seeing it everywhere. But there is a version of it I like. I said, the version I like is no grief for yourself. Because your real problem now yourself. So this year, tell yourself, I no go grief for myself. I no go sleep like as I did sleep before. No grief for yourself. This one I say, no grief for anybody. This year, no grief for what?
Myself.
No grief for yourself. Train yourself harder. Work harder on improvement. Huh? Work harder on what? Improvement. If you already have a skill, find a way to make your skill more digitized. Find a platform where you do your design and you post to be able to reach more people. Find a way to make your whatever you are doing reach more people, to have more customers. So that as it's growing, you know that, oh, the way I am now, I need a staff. I can pay a staff 25,000 or 30,000. You start from there and you just keep building. You just keep building. Do you understand? Then, some of you have virtual business. Let's say you trade, you do trading, forex trading, or you do crypto. Now, if you are doing forex trading or you are doing crypto, don't leave your money in forex trading. Find a way to quickly have a supermarket or to have a thing physical, what is bringing daily money. Don't say Naira is falling. Let them be bringing the Naira like that. Have a physical business on ground so that when the stock market is shaking or Bitcoin is running mad, you know you have something that is a fallback. You are earning 25,000 Naira, no problem. Start from there. But tell yourself, in the next 6 months, I'm going to learn this alongside. Do you understand? Like someone came to meet me. She said she was earning 60,000. That comes to her every month. She resigned the 60,000 work. She said she wants to go and learn how to make air. Okay? That's foolishness. That's what? That's foolishness. That's not wisdom. You don't leave regular income and say you want to now go and learn a work that you are not receiving salary. I don't know if you understand. Okay, so that's not wisdom. What will happen to you is that there's something called reality. You will wake up one morning, there will be no transport to go and lie. So there will be no transport to go to where you want to learn the work. So you will now neither. No. I said you will neither do what? You will neither go and learn the work nor have a work. And you know what becomes your portion? Poverty and want will come as an armed man. And say, you are belloped. Are you sure you are getting me? So as you have something in your hand, don't throw it away. Find a way to learn. Some of you that are very good with phone, find a way to find out how all these kids people, how people are making money with blogging, how people are making money on YouTube. If you know that you are inclined in that direction, find a way. Do you understand? Don't allow this your mind be resting. Don't allow this your mind be resting. Wake up. Wake up in the night. Think about what to do. Do you understand? Mingle with people who are doing things the right way and learn from them. Then those of you that are academically inclined, take a course. You know you are a reader. Once you write exam, you always pass. Very good. Find out the course you need to take
that if you pass this course, it will help you get promotion in your office. Oh yeah, take the course. Do you understand? So I'm talking to every class of people. Those that don't have result, oh, no problem. If you don't have result, learn something. Do you understand? There are more than 100 and something to learn. It's better to go and learn mechanic work than to sit down and say you don't have money. It's better to learn carpentry work. Carpenters, I know how much carpenter charge me to do this roof. This roof you are saying, yes, almost 3 million. Carpenter. This one you are saying, carpenter. So they took 3 million. We know how much mechanic collect from our hand in a month in this Lagos. I know how much tailors collect also. So don't be looking at anything as though, as long as nobody will feed you, remove any shame and learn what you want to learn. Say, people will not see me that my clothes is dirty, I'm a mechanic. Eh? You are a mechanic, you are an engineer. You're an engineer. You are a mechanical engineer. Yes. After all, those that went to university, they go and carry the mechanic in the roadside to go and do the rework. They say we are directors. We are drawing it on paper. And be directing the other guys to do the rework. The guys are the ones entering under the car. So what are they are the ones that really know the work, the practical part. So what are you saying? So everybody here, nobody. I don't expect anybody here to be sitting. This is, then there's one thing I want to solve. If you are a member here, your job is marketing. You used to trek from Orile down to Oju Elegba. If that is your job, stop that work this night. This night, as I'm talking to you, so you are fired. I've fired you from here. I said, I have what? I've fired you from here. You say, sir, if I can close one, there's this 5 million, if this client is able to register this 5 million, they will give me 5% of the 5 million. That's 500,000. You are fired from that work now. How long have you closed one of the deal? This is 2 years, no salary. You are waiting on commission. In fact, any commission job, you are fired from it. If you close it, you get this potential. I say you are what?
Fired.
You're fired. Fired from it. So now, as you are fired, because I've already fired you, now that you have been fired, you will not go to work tomorrow again. Now, once you are just fired, Sonny has a design this thing. Uh-huh. If you are a male, Sonny has outfit. If you are a female, Shehu has outfit. Uh-huh. Locate any of them and start learning. Remove your face cap and start learning. Come down from your high horse. It's too high. Come down from the horse. Bring your brain down and learn. And stop trekking from Orile to this thing. January to December, you are waiting for commission. Every month and they don't pay you anything because you did not close any deal. What is wrong with you now? And you have started this year again because yesterday you were checking in Akwonjo. So may the Lord give you wisdom. Many of you, you cry so much. You cry with water in your eyes and you are not able to see what God is showing you. And a guy, after he left Abraham's house, he was crying. She was crying. Pool of water was by the side. The baby was dying of water. And the baby was crying to God because the baby was thirsty. A guy was crying, complaining about her situation. What happened at the end of the day, the angel of the Lord came and asked her, what is the problem? He said, my master and the wife have driven me away from the house and all that. And the angel of the Lord opened her eyes to see that there's well of water just beside her. So, well of water has been there. The water in her eye did not allow her to see the water that God has provided. So, which cry are you crying that is not allowing you to see? Wipe your tears. A testimony is near your way this year. For weeping may endure for a night. Joy is coming in the morning. It will not last for too long. God will make a way. So, don't despair. Don't become discouraged. Don't look at another person who is in his season. Remember, he bringeth forth his fruit in due season, in his season. So, in your own season, you will bring your own. So, when mango is bringing forth fruit, Coco is not supposed to be crying that mango fruit has come out. Oh, where is my Coco? Where is my Coco? It's not so. Coco has his own time. So, you have your own time.